So I was watching the Townsend's channel. You know what that is? It's the colonial sort of reconstruction guy who does all these Revolutionary War era sort of recipes and little things. So he had one for onion pie. And I thought, well, we've got onions, we got flour. And it turns out it's more than just onions. It's onions, potatoes, eggs, also called for apples, which we don't have. So I'm going to do the best I can and try to do a facsimile of this onion pie. So let's get started. Okay, let's start with the eggs, which need to be boiled. So I only have four, and another thing I like about the recipe is everything is in equal amounts. So this many eggs, I know how much to use of the potatoes and the onions. A little thing that I've learned about boiling eggs time-wise, because it is hard to get the time right. If you put them in the water, and then you let the water come to a boil, and you turn that boil off as soon as it starts, and let the eggs sit in there, a few minutes, that's usually exactly how much time they need. So you want to get these covered in water, bring it up to a boil, and turn it off. That's step one. Okay, so while the eggs are going, I'm going to make the pie crust. I'm going to use organic extra virgin olive oil in place of butter, baking powder, and some organic whole wheat flour. You can hear it's coming to a boil. Just going to turn it off and unplug it with one hand. Yes, we have a power strip behind here in the kitchen. Okay, let those sit and continue with the crust. Okay, so the flour container is a 21-ounce container, and I've used less than half of it, close to half, so call it, 9 ounces, maybe 10 ounces of flour in there. And why did I use baking powder? Well, I don't really want a flat pie. I want something that's kind of interesting. If you're making regular pie, you would want it to be flat. You would not want to use baking powder, but we're going to do a little spin on this. Here's the extra virgin olive oil. And that'll help weigh it down, too. So, not a lot, either. Maybe 2 tablespoons in there, and a little water. Okay, so I've also added some salt and pepper in there. I don't want it to be a bland dough. And I'm just going to put water as needed here. So we'll start off with just a little there, and we'll see how it works in. And the eggs should be pretty much ready, except they're really hot right now. So I'm going to plunge them into some cool water. And then we should have our components ready so we can really start making more rapid progress on this. So what I have here is a really crumbly dough, almost the kind of thing you'd want in a dessert pie involving apples and stuff. But now that I've stirred it, I'm going to work with my hands and smooth it out. Okay, I've got a metal pie plate that I've buttered. Not too much butter in the middle. We'd want the middle to be soggy and collapsing. Want it more on the outside. And I've got the dough worked, and I'm going to get one big-ass rolling pin and work this out. Just how big of a rolling pin, you ask? It's a pretty big rolling pin. So we'll get this started and should make fairly short work of this. Okay, that's pretty good. And I'm going to get it up with a spatula. That sounds kinky. Okay, ASMIR people out there, check this out. We want this to release without much of a struggle. Not much damage either. Okay. got the pan at the ready here. Let's get it in frame just a little more. And can I do this neatly? Probably not. But the thing is, when I get this up and warm. Okay. That's fine. I'm not going to complain about that. Okay, so you can see I got it draped over the pie plate here. Plenty of room to spare. And I'm going to trim the edges and use those edges to make the top. Okay, edges trimmed. Now, I do not recall this recipe calling for docking the pie, but what that is you take a fork and you just make lots of holes there to prevent the crust from rising too much. I don't think this recipe did it. I think they wanted like an actual seal in the juices sort of thing here. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, now the recipe called for putting butter in the bottom of the pie, but I'm not going to do that. For a little more flavor, I thought I'm going to put a little bit of mayonnaise and minced garlic, and somewhere in this whole mixture, I'm going to put some salted anchovies, believe it or not, because the flavor there, when it mixes with onions and garlic and all that, and potatoes, it won't really taste like anchovies. So, I'm going to try that out. Okay, so what we've got there is a coating of mayonnaise, minced garlic, marjoram, and black pepper. Okay, so the eggs have got cooling here, and they say they're easier to peel underwater. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so now I'm going to prep the onions and potatoes. The ratio isn't going to be exactly even. I might go for more onions and potatoes. And I'm going to put some fresh garlic in there as well. Okay, you're going to want to do the potatoes first, because there's no point in doing the onions first and getting your eyes all watery while you do the potatoes. So the video I saw said to slice them into onion ring type slices instead of mincing them, so that's what I'm going to do. Okay, in there I've added onion powder, garlic powder, paprika, marjoram, fresh ground black pepper, and I'm going to do the garlic, and I think I'm going to do some grated Romano in there too, tie it all together. So here's an anchovy, and I'm just going to make a kind of paste out of it. You don't want it whole in there. You want it incorporated into this for the flavor. So I've used the spatula to roughly crush the garlic cloves before we chop them up and add them in there. Crushing them releases even more garlic flavor, so that'll be good. So here it is blended up, and the recipe did call for mace and nutmeg to be added in here. I don't have mace, I have nutmeg. What I'm going to do instead is a middle ground, is to add some allspice. So now we're going to start to get all of this piled high in the pie plate. Okay, so that came up piled pretty high. I've used most of what was in there though. So now for the top. Okay, it was too big to completely seal, but I'm still going to put just a couple little slits along the top so drainage can happen if it needs to. And it's ready for a 350 oven. Okay, that should cook at 350 for 45 minutes, possibly a little longer, but definitely check it around the 40-minute mark at least. So there's just a quick check here. It's been in there about 20 minutes or so. The top is not browning or blackening, so that's a good sign. I'll see how it is later. Here it is after cooking for 45 minutes and probably sitting for 5 minutes or so. Put it on the table and see how it looks closer up. So, as a recap, it's equal proportions approximately of onions and potatoes, although I think I have a little more onion than potato in there. Also, what else? Let's see. Just trying to adjust the zoom on this and get a little closer. There. Well, you can just, well, you've watched the video. You know it's in here better than me. It's been 45 minutes since I've had to think about this. We'll cut it open and we'll see what's in there ourselves. Okay, so I think maybe Laurie should do the honors of cutting this.
There he is in there.
Hey, we don't have to film the whole thing, so you can take your time. Well, one thing for sure is that it's hot. The crust is crunchy, crusty, I believe. And the taste is what?
It's good.
Oh, okay, good. So, that's today's little experiment. Okay, having had a piece, the crust, it's thin, and even though I put in the baking powder, it didn't really rise, so I hate to think what would happen without the baking powder. The whole wheat flour is a little heavier anyway. It doesn't work the same way as the white stuff. Also, it wasn't as savory as I was hoping for. Now, that might just be because I was conservative with the salt. So in place of adding salt directly, I used the sardine and the grated Romano as salt. Oh, the anchovies, yes. It's the same damn thing, really. So yeah, a little more savoriness in there. And surprisingly, even though there was a liquid content, there was absolutely no liquid content when cooked. So the eggs and the potatoes really soaked that up. So maybe even a little more liquid content next time. And maybe something, just a little freshness like parsley in there too would be good. So not too bad, certainly a good meal. And it'll be better the next time you do it.